Yeah, so thank you, Shelomo, for agreeing to talk to me on this. It's been a pleasure working with you over the past few months. And for the benefit of the audience, if you can please tell us a bit more about yourself and your background and what led you to data and analytics.
Sure. And it's been a real pleasure working with you and Vikas on this project. It's been a lot of fun, as we'll discuss. So my background is really interesting. I started my career in 2000 with a degree in visual communications, which, and at that point, everyone was, you know, starting to look at website design. So I got into there playing with Netscape Navigator, you know, only us folks remember what that is. And that led to front end development, but I've always had an interest in the development world, and sort of that combination of business, UX, and the development really led me to the position I am today with Orthodox Union, and that's the director of product development. Something that's a little different about working within a Jewish nonprofit is because we are a smaller team, but acting like a technology startup, all facets of the development world are under me. So we have DevOps, UX, we have front-end develop, back-end development, mobile development, and now data analytics. So it really gives me a unique opportunity to really be involved with the full flow and really see how all the pieces fit together, which is not something that everyone gets to do in this position.
Yeah, so that's lucky. And I've had a front-end experience watching you while working with you side by side. So if you could, put in more details about Orthodox Union per se and what kind of applications you have out there.
Sure. So the Orthodox Union is an umbrella organization that services the Jewish communities from age zero till the end. Right, we're going across all facets of the Jewish community, Jewish life. Of course, our one of the main things that Orthodox Union is known for is kosher food certification, but all that feeds back into supporting the communities. So every large piece of the organization, every department has a CRM that we've built for them. We're running over 40 websites. We have five mobile applications deployed. So we really do work like a technology startup. It's an honor to be working here, and we do a lot of good.
Yeah, so there are a lot of good causes, and I'm sure a lot of data flowing in. So if you would like to kind of share the kind of data initiatives you have, especially around the whole warehousing initiatives that you have in place right now.
Sure. So actually the data initiatives has started like a pipe dream about 10 years ago for me, as we were like building system 2 and 3 out, we were trying to think how can we start bringing some of this data together. On our first attempt back then was a centralized user database, which didn't work out, and we had to decouple because we were overriding users' data, and there were unique needs. There was a lot of thought over the next few years of how could we achieve something, but the team just, we weren't there yet, and the technology wasn't there in terms of something that would address all our needs. With the current EVPs at the Orthodox Union, Josh Joseph made a huge push for data and being data driven, and he's really giving us the support needed to push this through. We reinvigorated the data warehousing project, where the goal is to take the pieces from all our different CRMs, from all the different websites, and build out our golden records. And that's the start of anyone's journey when it comes to working with data.
Sure. So what kind of challenges were there that prompted you to search for entity resolution? And what really is the driver behind the entity resolution project?
Yeah, so we have these different data sources, and being able to match people, find the duplicates, find who belongs with who. And again, we also have a very strong connection for households, not just individual people. Doing that across all systems and keeping the system still decoupled was always a challenge. And we were looking at different tools, some reverse ETL tools, but we didn't really find anything that fit. And our first, we were going to start by writing our own matching logic. And that's when we found Zingg open source. That was our first contact during this research phase.
And so here we are. So I think coming to Zingg, we've got the implementation going and there is a flow in place. So just wanted to understand really, from your side, what's been the experience like and what is the flow that you've built and how are you planning to consume this data?
Yeah, so we're taking a multi-strategy approach. We have Airbyte, which is shipping the data from our databases, Postgres, Mongo, into Snowflake. And then we also have some external data coming in through Fabric connections. And then again, once everything is in Snowflakes, we're in the medallion process where we have the bronze, silver, gold data doing our cleansing, working with DBT. But then, before we come to output, that's where Zingg sits. And instead of building our own and then having Zingg open source, which we initially looked at, taking over like whatever we couldn't match ourselves, we took a step back when we saw that you started offering an enterprise version sitting on top of Snowflake, and we put Zingg first and you're the engine that's powering building out our golden records.
Yeah, so it's been quite a journey and a lot of building with all the feature requests and things that we've built together. So would you like to talk a bit about some of the cool things that you've driven us to build?
Yeah, I love this. I love that I was able to take a part in the project. When we work with people, I think it's really important to build those connections. And when you're able to build something out together, it's really a win-win for everyone. So I think some of the challenges along the way were, within Snowflake, just making sure we're optimized. I think our first challenge was taking the rundown from like 12 hours to, what was it, 3 during the initial. So that was great. And I guess the biggest piece of all this was really working on the incremental piece, which was key. We want to run it more than once a day, and we don't want to have to loop through everything every time we make a change to one of the data sets. So being able to batch 4, 6, 8 times a day and have those changes update the records was crucial. And I think it's a crucial feature for Zingg. It's really going to set you apart. And it's really exciting that we got here. We really did a lot of stress testing on it. But we're in an unbelievable place now because of it.
Yeah, so it's been an absolute thrill ride building this along with you, and it's been a fun tough project, but yes, a lot of learning on the way as well, and the product is definitely far more mature since we started. So thanks a lot for all that feedback and all the requests and ideas. It's been fun building together. So coming back to, I think, the problem, how are you planning to consume the Zingg results going forward in your operational systems? Are you planning to look at them, yes, through an ETL pipeline or something like that?
So the plan is once we have our production ready table from Zingg, there's a couple of places we want to ship it to. We're shipping to our BI tools, We're shipping, we want to do a reverse ETL into our existing system. So we'll set up a subscription-based model where tool X could say, okay, I see something changed with that golden ID. If it's crucial, then we'll push it into the system. If it's something not crucial, we'll ask the consumer, do you want to update this entity with this piece of information? So we're going to leave a lot of choice in the hands of the businesses. We're also planning on outputting to OpenSearch, so we could have an enterprise-wide search that could be embedded also in each of the application without having to build it out, but could also be peppered with data from each of the systems alongside that golden record. So a lot.
Yeah, quite a lot. And I'm glad that Zingg fits in so beautifully in, you know, being a critical part of that architecture. I think coming to households, that's something that was very interesting and exciting as we build this along with you. So just wanted to hear a bit more from your side about that.
Yeah, so after we build out the individuals model, we started working on households. And a lot of people are always interested in more than just the nuclear household. They're asking about grandparents, cousins, so on. So when we built that first model and we were reviewing it, we saw like households with 30 people, and we started looking, is this correct? And we had these huge family trees, so it worked a little better than I expected it to. I think, and now, you know, we're working on restricting a little bit more, but really it just shows how powerful Zingg really is, and it's just amazing what we were able to find there and the quality of the search. It was all proper data. It was just, you know, it was a little much.
Yeah, that's true. I mean, I think we could have constructed family trees out of models that we have created. Oh, yeah. So I know you've been very happy with the person model and the accuracy we've achieved there, but just wanted to, you know, get your view there.
Yeah, I mean, when I went to present some of the findings, I was really surprised. After Zingg runs and we have all our matches, we're looking for anything under like a 0.8 score, and we'll have to do like a manual review of that data set. And I thought, because of the type of data we have and some of it being older and messier, that we'd be in the thousands or the tens of thousands. And at the end of the day, even between 0.65, 0.7 and 0.8 were really clean. There's almost everything there we could pull back. And anything under 6, they were only, I think, around somewhere in the 1,000 range. I was very surprised about how well we matched and how well the results are. It was really unbelievable. It far exceeded our expectations.
I think that makes our day and all the effort kind of worth it. So I guess anything that you would like to share as part of your experience or just in general?
I really want to thank you. I love the journey. I love the ride. And we've talked about others' collaborations in terms of UI work. And I think it'd be great for us to keep working together in this capacity. And I'm really excited and invested in to see where Zingg goes from here.
No, we definitely need all the support, and I don't think we could have come this far without, you know, you being the early, we talk about the visionary founder, but I think it's the visionary early adopters and the customers who actually pulled the product out. So it's just been amazing, and thank you for sharing this. I think if nothing, I'm going to be really, really, you know, whenever I'm down, I'm going to look at this video and and pull myself back again if there's a nasty bug or something doesn't work out the way it does. But it's just been fun working together. And yes, let's build more stuff around this.
Yeah.
Yeah. Thank you so much, Shelomo.
Thank you.